How to make a 3D wine bottle in Adobe Illustrator. Hey guys, Kerry Hawkins here with another VectorMade.com tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a 3D model of a wine bottle in Illustrator. This is going to be very similar to the 3D model of the coffee mug that we made where we put the logo on that. But there might be a few changes, so let's just jump right in, shall we? The first thing you're always going to want to do is grab some source image like this, and then we're going to grab our pen tool. We're going to start about the middle here, and don't worry about these like slight curves here because this isn't exactly flat. It is facing us, but you know it's three-dimensional too. In real life, this when they took the picture, obviously this is three-dimensional, so there's a little bit of perspective, and we don't need to worry about that. We're just going to kind of come out here, and I wouldn't worry about these corners either. Just make everything really square, and just basically come in about as far as it comes in where the rounded parts are. You don't have to be perfect on this. This can all be altered later, but just sort of making these notches basically is all you're worried about at the moment. And then we'll add some further detail later. And here's the curve around here. I'm just clicking and dragging so that I get what I want. I'm holding shift so that this line goes straight up and down. I'm zooming out a little bit here. And just to zoom out, you know, you hold alt up and down on the mouse wheel. And if you need to go left or right, that's control. So you'll see me do mixtures of control and alt all the time. Get used to doing that. It makes workflow much faster. We're going to click about here probably to create a little bit of a curve. And then I think we'll go ahead and just, yeah, this should be aligned. Is that correct? Let's see if we aligned. Yeah, that's going to be perfect. So we're going to leave that just like that. I'm going to go ahead and hit D to fill it in with a fill and a stroke so we can see it. I'm going to pull this away. Let's just do that stroke for now. I'm going to go ahead and use the eyedropper tool, hotkey I, to grab this color. And then I'm going to shift X to flip this over to where it's just a stroke. See, you can also do that with this little nifty arrow right here. And then I'm going to come up to effect and we're going to go, 3D revolve. And then you want the axis to be on the front position here. You want to go from the right edge. And let's do fewer options for now. We'll come back to this later. But go ahead and click on that and see what happens. Perfect. Angles 360. That looks exactly like we want. You've got the start of a wine bottle. Now, we'll want to like round these edges. See, these things aren't notched quite as hard as what we have here. But this is really easy. If you just hit A, your direct selection tool up here, then you can come in and kind of round things as needed. I would just grab several of these on the outside. I'm shift clicking to grab multiple to pull those in like that. You might even want to come in. I'm switching with control Y to outline view. You can also go view. Where is that? No, I forget where it is. Preview. There we go. Preview and outline right there. I do control Y so often I don't even remember where it is. So I'm going to grab these in here and probably give them just a little bit of a rounded feel as well. If I can, let's see. Maybe I need to back up just a little bit. I may have grabbed too many points. Probably. So let's try that. Okay. Yeah. Now let's see what that looks like. That looks pretty good. We might add a little notch right in here, and I'm just using the plus tool, the plus key rather, to add points to this, and then I might click and drag and bring one in, see what that does. See, that adds just a little bit of a line. And if that's too much, you can always bring this back up a little. Let's see. Wonder if that gets rid of it completely, and it does. Let's just leave it like it was. That'll work. That'll look pretty cool. All right, now obviously I don't want the whole thing to be black. I would like this top part to be white. What I do is I'll click and drag this over here, and then I'm gonna click and hold shift, and I'm also gonna hold alt to make a copy. And I'm going to delete all the points that don't belong to this sort of top here. Let's see if I bring you back up. About where is that? Now I'm going to hit Control R to bring the rulers, and then I'm going to kind of click and drag a line, and you should see this cyan line here. That shows you where there's the kind of the top of the bottle and sort of the bottom of the that top wrapper. So I'm going to bring this. I'm going to do this, add a couple more points using the plus key, and we're going to go add one here. I don't know why I was trying to add one over on that side. There isn't anything over here. So there you go. And then I'm going to delete this. That will be the bottle, and this will be the sort of wrapper up at the top. And let's do white. And then I can bring these back together to see what they look like. I'm also going to do this. I'm going to double click on here to isolate that group, and I'm going to select this very top here and just push it out ever so slightly so that this top part is slightly larger than the bottom and overlap them just slightly. Now I'm going to turn these guides off by hitting Control and semicolon so that I can see. That looks really good. Now, let's say we want to get something similar as far as the sheen and stuff goes over here. Let's go into Appearance. Once this is selected, obviously, go to Appearance, and you'll double click on this 3D Revolve, which will bring up your options. Always hit Preview because it will default to no preview for some reason. I hate that it does that, but that's probably to save you on memory. And then click More Options. Let's do diffuse shading for this one. It'll look a little bit more matte. And then I'm going to bring that all the way over here, and I'm going to click this new light, which will put one in the middle, and I'm going to bring it over here. And let's bring it in ever so slightly, maybe more like this, and just see what that does. I'm going to drop the intensity to 70. Maybe this one will be dropped a little as well. This can get kind of tedious, and it's really hard to tell because you might move just a little bit, but it might make a huge difference over here on your preview. 90, 80 is fine. I am also going to change this color to a custom color instead of, let's just use a really light gray and see how that does. Too light. Let me try this one. Maybe this one. Let's go a little darker. That'll work. I think that's fine. I may play with it just a little bit more. That's what I always say. Just a little more. Maybe make this one really white, so that there's a little contrast. Anyway, I think that looks fine. You know, you could mess with this as much as you want, but I see nothing wrong with that. Let's do the same thing for this one and go to Appearance, double click on 3D Revolve, click that preview. Plastic shading, I think, is going to work better here. I'm going to add another point of light, and really that's about what it looks like in the picture. It's pretty close. I think we're good, and we'll just say yeah. So there you go. You have the basics of the bottle, kind of what it looks like over here. You could go in and add a few other details if you wanted to with your own pen tool to add some of this stuff, but I don't want to mess with that. Let's go back in. I already made a symbol, and I'll show you. It's up here in my symbol. Let me double click on it just to open. This is sort of my wine label that I put together real quick before we did anything. And anyway, we'll go ahead and exit out of that. And if you come over here to 3D Revolve again hit preview, and map art. I'm going to drag this over so you can see. We're going to map this to the bottle. Now, if you click through these to next, you should see the surface highlighted in red there. It looks like we'd want that one, but if I recall, it's actually like one of these, probably eight. Let's see. That's one thing I don't like about Illustrator is that it's really hard to tell which surface you're talking about. Is it the one behind or the one in front? And this can take a little while. It may have to render it a couple of times, actually. Let's put it right about here because this should be the front side. See what that looks like. Yep. And that's probably a little bit big. So what you could do is come in and drag these. If you hold shift, you're going to proportionally shrink that down in size. And let's just drag it over here. And maybe even just a little bit smaller. See what that looks like. Yeah. I think you can even shade it too if you want. I don't know what that's going to look like. Let's click. See if that looks good. Ooh. No, because then it looks like it's part of the bottle. Maybe a little too much. I'm not sure I like that. It does give it a little more depth, but you know, if we untick it, then it looks more like it's on top. So we'll just hit OK. And there you go. There's your wine bottle that you can then play with, you know, positioning of this. And if you want to kind of show it from the side, or maybe if you have a back label, like some sort of information on the vineyard or something like that, then you could show the backside as well. So anyway, that is the basic gist of the tutorial. Go ahead, like, subscribe, leave a comment down below to help me grow the channel. And I will see you guys in the next video.